We did it backwards.
75.
Family, stability, then trying to get it out there. Right.
Hey, sir, how are you?
This is Joseph Eborn. And he's chilling in his spare time. It's Joe Eborn Studio in Little Young Angel.
This is a piece of my daughter and my son. And I kind of merge their faces together. I got it from, I got it from this image right here. And I thought it'd be cool to do the same thing with their faces. So it's just the oil wash over top of the pencil, just to create a tone. And, but that's it.
And with that technique, you just like do the drawing.
Turn up oil just to get that color, that pigment with turpentine. You just lay it over top of your drawing. It gives a whole tone and sets like the structure for the undercoating of the picture that you're doing. And then you just go back and rework, you know, your details over top of that. It's about layering, basically.
But this is an Erica Badu joint.
Yeah, that's a picture of Erica that I do. I really like her hair wraps. So I'm getting into
it. And your wash is like kind of loose.
Yeah. That's just the painting I'm doing of Javon and his cousin. And that's really, I'm going to have to go over there. I might just really just paint it straight with a brush as opposed to trying to do a wash.
Yeah.
That's the stage that
it's basically the same technique.
Polish. And I really liked it. And I knew I wanted to do something with it, but I didn't know what. So it took all of this time for me to figure out what I wanted to do. When I saw it was black and white.
So is this like one of the sacrifices that you make being an artist?
Yeah, it kind of is. Ever since when I graduated, even though I had a degree in what I wanted to do, I kind of had these little odd jobs because I didn't want to work for anybody and do artwork or illustration and like in a marketing type of field. I wanted to do my own thing. So one of the sacrifices is, you know, a realistic thing is paying bills. I got bills. I got a wife, two kids, a car note, mortgage, so I got to pay bills. So I would get these odd jobs like this where it's not really that much work involved and have enough to sustain to pay my bills and still freelance and do my own thing. It's the only drawback is you don't get paid as much as you want, but if you just look at it as just as something that's temporary, I guess it's beneficial to you.
Like, is it possible for you to do any type of work here while you're at this job?
Not really getting the artwork done, but a lot of research, because so, I got the internet and, you know, computers and copy machines and all that kind of stuff, so I can do anything I want research wise. But actual studio time is still had to be manipulated into my own little personal time.
This is an older picture I did of Aaliyah, my tribute to Aaliyah when she passed. It's done in a lot of different mediums and techniques. Tried to combine all of them into one big picture. I think I did a pretty good job. I'm really, really in love with this piece. I love the detail, and I just love just everything that's going on. It's telling the story.
I think what I really want to do is use this as a tool to actually do some art related. I still want to freelance to do my own thing, but I was since I've been here maybe a year and a half. I'm thinking that I might take classes, a few courses, maybe two, in networking in terms of IT, and that'll be another way to secure a job that's, I mean, kind of easy, something to do that's easy in terms of help desk, and from that translate that into a web and try to incorporate the art that way. That'll be a way of me using this and kind of mixing the two together. So to be honest, I don't know in terms of time frame. It depends on I don't know.
Let's go over here. This is a picture of Mingus, Charles Mingus, that's in progress, work in progress. Just wanted to let you see what a brother's working on. This up here is my next piece. It's going to be my tribute to these great hip-hop icons. Big Pun to the left, Notorious B.I.G., Tupac, and Jam Master Jay. Of that image. It's going to be very, very dramatic when I'm done with it in terms of technique and colors. These are two pictures that I'm working on now. That's one image of Dizzy that I'm actually going to do. That's the drawing there. This is a Wynton Marcellus piece that I'm working on. And that's Wynton under there. That's my latest work. My picture of Diz. Blowing the bubble. Dig the irony with the bubble in the cheeks. Nobody does it better than Joey. This is a picture for my coworker that I'm working on. It's still in the black and white phase. But I think this is some really good pencil work, so I wanted to document it so she could take a look at it. And this is her dog. Adding color to this weekend. But I felt that I needed to get this on film right now. Starts off with the pencil, and when you add color to it, it's only as good as the pencil. So I took a lot of time and relaxed and did extensive pencil work on the image before I actually added color. Usually when I do oil washes, it's not rushed, but it's not too much thought put into the pencil. I just get the shapes and shadows down, and I just throw the wash over. This time I took my time because I'm dealing with texture and fur and on a dog and all kinds of things, and I wanted to, you know, get something interesting going on. This is a portrait of me and my mom I was messing around with one day. It's an older picture of my mom with the afro, and that's me when I was a young kid with a patch on my eye and my glasses. This is kind of a wash. I didn't get too detailed in it. It was real quick. And I think I captured it really quick. I kind of like it just like that. This is my Mick Jagger piece. I'm really fond of that image right there. In terms of the color, is fresh. It's real vibrant. My least image that I like in this picture is the airbrush one at the end. There's something about it that I don't like. And the middle image needs to be worked on some more, which I will do, and I'll try to fix this up. But overall, it's mine, so I gotta love it. I did this picture in one sitting, one day. This is 30 by 40. Look at that. Janet Jackson. Isn't she lovely? You gotta love the cigar. Oh, let me zero in on this. Check out Janet smoking a cigar and how I made the smoke from the cigar. turn into my signature. Bio Bio, Eborn. You like that? 2001. You gotta love that. You gotta love that. I mean, I do what I can do when I can do it. What we're doing now is we're filming the process of the picture. This is the wash that I put over top of the drawing. And I have to say, I blended it in with a brownish, reddish wash and a yellow ochre fur. And I'm using that as a background color. This wash came out excellent. I'm gonna pick out the highlights and I will come back and film after I pick up the highlights. You can see a little bit of it right there where I started. Here we go. Here is the picture with the highlights picked out. All the light spots are where highlights are on the picture. So by doing this, it helps me set my pattern and lay down my pencil work. Some finishing touches, but pretty much that's the gist of the picture. She's done. Next thing you will see is the picture in the frame.
Not all I want. I want to be happy.
You want to be
happy? So being the happy, finances is really what's going to make you happy?
No, I'm not just saying that. Yeah, I'm saying I want to be happy first. Doing what I want to do, but also taking care of my responsibilities.
See, but what you just said at first is what I'm saying.
You're dirt.
Well,
you just weren't indifferent.
You said the money didn't.
And I can honestly say, I'm not going to sacrifice myself and my life for what I love to do. And what I mean by that, I'm not saying I ain't gonna fight for it, but
I'm not gonna give up one.
I'm not giving up my kids and my wife and my family. You know what I'm saying?
Just
me. Y'all did my thing. I'm gonna find it's a balance out there.
There is a balance.
It is. But fighting with it. And I just kept saying, I stopped making excuses. Okay, I'm not here because this. Instead of saying no, it's always a way.
It's always.
It's about how much are you gonna fight.
You find out that there's a balance, that it can be done, let's search for that way.
We asked them about.